Only if one pill could cure all the diseases of the world. You see, unfortunately, that's not the case. And that's also not the case with Photoshop. So that's why today I'm giving you 5 ways to selectively adjust colors in Photoshop. First questions first, why you might want to selectively adjust colors? Here's why. 2 reasons. To enhance colors and to change colors. First off, in this tutorial, we'll look at what to do when you have a lot of things going on in your image. Suppose you have red, suppose you have blue, suppose you have greens, you have yellows, you have a lot of things. Would you like select each color individually and adjust them? No, there's an easy way to do it. Next, what if your image has an object, say it is red, and you want to change the color or enhance the color of that object, but your image has another object, maybe a red building, and you don't want to touch it? What to do then? We'll look at it next. Then we'll look at how to change colors or replace colors in a destructive way, then in a non-destructive way. Don't get me wrong. Why I'm telling you the destructive way when you have the non-destructive way? Both has its pros and cons, right? Both has an advantage over the other. And at the end, I have saved the best technique for the end. Are you ready for this? Watch. If that didn't get you excited, I don't know what would. You see, there's barely any tool that can make your object black or white with such ease. So some of you might say, why not just limit the tutorial to that kind of method? Here's why. That method also has its cons, which others don't have. So you need to know all the pills, because if you know just one, your disease might never be cured, or worse. So without any further ado, let's get started. So that was a bit powerful though. Let's get started. The first method, which some of you might already be aware of, is Camera Raw itself. So whenever you import a raw image into Photoshop, Camera Raw will automatically open. But in case if it's not a raw image, I'll tell you what to do. So this is a raw image girl on the phone. If I drag and drop it into Photoshop or import it into Photoshop, you see, Camera Raw will automatically appear. In case it doesn't, suppose, let's pretend that it didn't appear, let's open the image. Then what you gotta do? The image is now opened. And in case you imported a JPEG image or not a raw image, your image would have imported directly like this. In that case, all you need to do, let's just unlock the background layer. To unlock it, just click on the lock. I do it usually, right click on it and convert it to smart object. Always do this whenever you're working with Camera Raw filter. Now go to filter and then Camera Raw filter. Why did we convert it into smart object? Well, when you make changes, suppose you make changes to exposure, then you clicked OK. What happens is, since this is a smart object, what will happen is that if you double click on the Camera Raw filter, you can tweak it again. If this was not a smart object, that would never have been possible. See, exposure is still on 2.1 that we had changed. Now, about the color. Select the hue, saturation or luminance / grayscale. That's what HSL stands for. Click on that, this icon, and the color panel will appear. Here you have every color just like a slider and you can edit them separately. So here is the hue. All you need to know is that hue changes the colors, right? It does nothing. It doesn't brighten the color, it doesn't darken the color, does nothing, but changes the color. Suppose you want to change the red, take it to the right, take it to the left, and it changes the colors accordingly. You want to change the blues, right, left, accordingly. What saturation does, this is the saturation tab, and what it does is it amplifies the intensity of colors, alright? So if I take the slider to the right, reds will become more red. If I take it to the left, reds will become less red. And all the way down the line, it becomes black and white, right? Take the oranges, and it also becomes black and white. All the way to the right, 100%. Total intensity, high power, 100%, all right? Okay, so that was saturation. Also goes with blue, whatever. You get the idea what I'm talking about, right? Luminance. Luminance is the brightness of the color. If you take the slider towards the right, you see the reds getting brighter It's not increasing the intensity of the color, neither it is decreasing, but it's increasing the brightness. Watch. Increasing the brightness, decreasing the brightness, making it darker, making it brighter. Now, how to remember them? Well, when you're in hue, you see in the slider itself, there are different colors. If you move towards the right, it shows that it's going to be orange. If you move towards the left, it shows that it's going to be magenta-ish. If you look at the saturation tab, you can see that on the left hand side, it's gray, on the right hand side, it's the complete color. So if you move towards the right, the colors will increase, move towards the left, it will become grayscale or black and white. In the luminance slider, as you can see, on the right it's complete white, on the left it's complete black. In the middle you have the color, so if you move towards the right it will be brighter, if you move towards the left it will be darker. Self-explanatory. Now this method is good when you have a lot of colors in your image. You have a landscape and you have to edit a lot of colors. This is much time saving and this is an awesome thing. This will do your work 90% of the time, 90% of your images. Only in specific images, you might want to move to the other four methods. Now, what are the limitations of this? The limitation is, it doesn't say what amount of red is selected, what amount of red are you tweaking. So, suppose I'm okay, in decrease the saturation of it, the sum of the red is remaining, right? If you decrease the saturation of orange, it also goes away. But it also decreases the color of other areas. So what if I want to determine, okay, this to this, this red, okay, this shade of red to this shade of red. I want this section to be selected and removed. Then you have a problem. You cannot do this in Camera Raw. One more essential thing you cannot do. Suppose, as in this example, as you can see, you have this red wall, okay, and when I increase the saturation, the red wall becomes more red. But you see this red on the door? I didn't want to edit it. Suppose I want to keep it as it is. Then you have a problem here. So that's when you move on to the other steps. So this was one of the steps. Let's move on to the next example. In this example, suppose I want to change the color of this flower. What's the color of this flower? Magenta pinkish, right? And there are other flowers of the same color and I don't want to touch them. What to do? We use select color range, alright? Go to select color range. In color range, make sure you decrease your fuzziness to 0. Okay, let's zoom in quite a bit and select the eyedropper tool right here. Click on the flower, an area where the color is even. Now once you click, as you can see, just one point is selected. Now what is this? This is the area which shows which areas are selected, which areas are not selected. Black are the areas which are not selected, white are the areas which are selected. Now, this just picked up just a point. We want to select more of the flower, we want to select more of the color. What do you do then? Press and hold shift. And when you hold shift, watch, the eyedropper tool changes to an eyedropper plus. Or what you can do, you can select this eyedropper plus tool, but you won't have the versatility of jumping from plus to minus and to neutral. Alright, so let's select the eyedropper tool, press and hold shift, start clicking on the areas which are of similar color. Pro tip, you can even drag it, you can even draw on the colors. So press and hold the mouse button, left mouse button, and start drawing. And bingo, you have it, right? You have selected all the colors. Instead of just clicking once, just hold the mouse, left mouse button, hold shift, and draw a line. Okay? You see, most of the color is selected. But as you can see, the selection is a little harsh. Okay? Then you would increase the fuzziness. The fuzziness is the smoothness or the transition between the areas which are selected and the areas which are not selected. Okay, increase the fuzziness to a point where whole of the flower is selected. But if you increase it too much, what will happen is other parts will also begin to be selected. As you go ahead with increasing the fuzziness, more similar colors come into the selection. Alright, so you have to be at a happy place where just the flower is selected. But as you can see, some of the other flowers are selected as expected. We'll take care of that. Click OK. Alright, now the selection has been done. Delete the areas which are not required. Select the lasso tool, Press and hold Alt or Option, you see it has turned minus, then select the areas you don't want. Okay? Gone! Amazing! Now, you have a mask, right? What do I mean by that? We'll get to it in a minute. Create an adjustment layer. This one is the icon for adjustment layer. Create an adjustment layer of hue saturation. Now, as you can see, the hue saturation adjustment layer has appeared with this mask. Okay? Now, if you change hue saturation, click on this to bring back the properties. If you change hue saturation, it will only affect this flower. Isn't that amazing? One of the other things that you can do is you can check the colorize option. That way, what will happen is it will discard all the previous colors that this flower has, and you can color this flower from the very beginning. This is the hue, you can change the hue. This is saturation, the intensity of the color, and this is lightness. This is same as luminosity, the what we had in Camera Raw. So this is one of the ways. Now, what are the advantages of this way? Well, the biggest advantage that this has is that now you have a mask. Suppose you want to increase the contrast of the same area of flower. So suppose you want to have a brightness contrast and you increase the bright, okay, you decrease the brightness, you increase the contrast, but you want to limit it to just this flower. You can copy this mask to this adjustment layer. Press and hold Alt and drag this mask over to this one. And leave it. Replace layer mask, say yes. Now as you can see, if I click on this properties of brightness and contrast, if I increase or decrease it, it will just affect the flower. So the biggest advantage is, you'll have a mask of this particular area. And whatever you want to do with it, you can do with it. Okay? So this is about using color to create a selection. When your selections are difficult to create, you can use this method to select the color. And then allow that color to make a selection you want to make, either to remove a background. If a background is completely blue, you can use this method to totally remove the background. All right, that would be a great thing to do. Let's move on to the next method and the next example. In this example, we would do it destructively. Why? This has its own advantage. What advantage? We'll get to that in a minute. All right, there's an option in image adjustments called replace color, exactly what we need. But here's the thing, this is a smart object, alright? If you go to image adjustment, you see replace color grayed out. The biggest problem with this is that it doesn't work with smart objects. I wish Photoshop would work on this soon. But for now, this is 2017, the latest version I have. What we'll do is, we'll duplicate this layer and make the duplicate raster. To do it, right click on it, rasterize layer. It rasterizes the layer. Now you go to image adjustments, replace color. It's same as select color range, but non-destructive, doesn't give you a selection. Alright, eyedropper tool, select the color you want. Okay, selected. And as I told to you, hold shift, draw on the coat. Okay, make sure the fuzziness is zero, start drawing. Okay. Alright, you see most of the coat is now selected, or jacket, I don't know what it's called. It must be a coat, jacket, alright. Okay, so as you can see, it's fairly selected. Now you can change the color. You have the hue, saturation, lightness, you have everything right here. So you can change whatever color you want. Now what is the advantage of this? Okay, this area is left, so yeah, I might want to select it. Alright, the plus, let's select this area. Okay, this area is left out. Let's select this. Okay. What is the advantage of this? The biggest advantage that replace color has is that you double click on it, watch. You can select any color in the world you want. You have the full control. You don't have to mess with hue. You don't have to mess with saturation. You don't have to mess with lightness. You can select the color you want. Okay? Now, once your color is decided, you're happy with it, you click okay. And then it's there. And it's the biggest drawback of this. You cannot change the color. Unlike the previous method, where you can always go ahead, go to the properties, tweak the hue, saturation, lightness, in this, you cannot do any of it. So that's why, that's the biggest drawback. But the advantage is, you can select any color in the world you want. Alright, so let's move on to the next example. This method works amazingly and awesomely, and you should use this method when you have mainstream colors in your image like red, green, blue, cyan, magenta, yellow. Then you might say, why to use it when you have the option in Camera Raw or Lightroom? Here's why. This gives you the option of mask. Suppose there are other red objects, as I told you before, that you don't want to be affected. You have the option to select it out, right? To do that, all you need to do, create a hue saturation layer, all right? Next, change from master to reds. That's all you had to do. Now change it however you want. Maybe you want it blue, all right? Decrease the saturation just a little bit, decrease the lightness. Now here's what happens. As you can see, this has affected other parts of the image also, which I don't want to be affected. So, we would simply go to the mask, take a brush, and start painting with black. What's happening? Okay, white is selected. Let's select black. X. Okay, press X to, you know, change the black and white, foreground, background. You get what I'm talking about. Okay, let's do it. And you paint over the area that you don't want to change. This is a bad example, I know, because if there was greens and yellows in the background, that wouldn't be affected. And since red is also there on her lips and some of the red on her face, it was affected. But you get the idea, right? Let's move on to the next example. I won't do this completely. I'm super lazy today. All right, the next example, where it is, and let me take a cut. You know why this is my favorite method to selectively adjust colors in Photoshop? Because this is the most accurate, most non-destructive, and this can give you the quality of color adjustment that no one else can give, no other tool can give, and no other method can give. And as I showed it to you in the beginning, it can make an object black and white, right? And none of the color adjustment methods that I explained to you just before this can do this. All right, let's jump straight in. So similar to other methods, here too, you have to create a hue saturation layer, but there is something different here. Instead of selecting red, green, blue, cyan, magentas, yellow, whatever, just zoom in. Suppose we want to change the orange color of this car. Click on this icon. An eyedropper tool will appear. With the eyedropper tool, click on the color of the car. You see a selection here. Okay, let's make it a little big so that it's easy for you to understand. You cannot see my face, I know, because that's replaced that, but that's fine. My face is not that beautiful. All right, now your objective is to change the hue all the way to the left or all the way to the right, just for the indication. Zoom out. As you can see, this car is also being affected and other things are also being affected in the background. We have to make sure that just this car is affected, that too, in a very smooth manner. Your second step would be to make this selection. This is the range of colors which is selected. Now, let's take a moment and understand what these two bars are. This is the input bar. This is how the color normally looks. And this, the bar which is below it, it's the output bar. As you change the hue, watch what happens in this section. Watch what happens. It changes, right? Just this section changes. So this is the area which is the output. This is the input. Now, selecting the perfect range is the biggest challenge. And once it's selected, you're the god of color. All right. So decrease it. Now, what are these? What's this? Okay, I get it. This is the range. Now, what are these extra things? Think of it as fuzziness. You might remember fuzziness from the select color range, right? You had a fuzziness slider. Increasing that slider made the transition from the areas that are selected from the areas that are not selected a little bit smoother, right? So as you increase the fuzziness, the more of the range would be selected and more smoother transition would become. So for now, as in that step, make the fuzziness zero from both the sides, even make the range a lot smaller. Now the color of the car has returned to its original. Now move the range from the middle. Stop at the point where whole of the car is selected. Okay, if I take it a little bit to the right, the car is again beginning to be deselected. So I'll take it to the left. Okay, so this is a happy place to be. Now as you can see, the selection is still very harsh. Now, you might want to increase the selection from here, increase the selection from here just a little bit. Okay, and then once you're happy with it, just increase the fuzziness just a little bit. And you have the selection of the car. Now watch. Watch what this does. You can have any color you want. Alright? Any color you want. You can have any saturation you want. It won't mess up. Any saturation you want. You can have any lightness you want. This is so amazing. You want a black car? There you have it. A black car. You want a white car? There you have it. A white car. Isn't this amazing? If that's not amazing, go ahead and dislike the video. But if that is, you gotta share this video. You have to. That's a compulsion. Alright? Now, as you can see, if I make this car white, this car is also becoming silver. Why? Because this car's color is similar to this one. Red and, you know, orange. They're kind of family brothers. So, let's deselect that. Let's remove that from the mask. That's the biggest advantage. Advantage of this. It gives you the adjustment that no one gives. Advantage number one. Advantage number two. It's non-destructive. If you want the change to be a little less, you can decrease the opacity. Advantage number three. If you want a certain area to not be affected, you can do that because this has a mask. Alright? So let's zoom straight in and let's start deleting it. How do we do that? Select the quick mask tool and start selecting the areas of this car. Okay? We'll try doing it a really quick job. Alright. It's a pretty good job, right? And, okay, amazing job right there. We don't want this area to be selected. Okay. So now once that separation is selected, all we needed to select was the separation. The outside areas can be brushed upon very easily, but separations need to be selected. Now this area is fixed. If I take a brush, black color, mask is selected, paint over it, boom, you have the color of the car back. Now you can go ahead and paint the other areas very easily. As you can see, the faces of people were also affected, but we can simply brush it up. Okay, so that's pretty good. All right, so we have it. I think we're pretty much done with the video, are we? Is there anything left you didn't understand? Oh, I forgot this was a video, not a live class. So that's pretty much it for this video. I'll see you guys in my next one. Till then, stay tuned and make sure that you keep creating. And also, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share the video. I'm running out of words, okay? Let's just end the video right now. Thanks a lot for watching. Peace. You know what? I just wanted to make this video in one take, and I forgot to add one little thing. Don't just subscribe, click on the bell button so that you don't miss anything. And that's finally the end.
Hope you enjoyed the video, and if you have any questions, do leave them down in the comments below, and I'll get back to them as soon as possible.